clergy are sitting with the queen.
Desire of the Lord that I will seek after that I may dwell.
The Lord is my light, my shepherd I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. He restored my soul. He leadeth me in the path of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod, thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of mine enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil. My cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. I will lift up my eyes unto the hills from which cometh my help. My help cometh from the Lord, which made heaven and earth. He will not suffer thy foot to be moved. He that keepeth will not slumber. Behold, he that keepeth Israel shall neither slumber nor sleep. The Lord is thy keeper. The Lord is thy shade upon thy right hand. The sun shall not smite thee by day, nor the moon by night. The Lord shall preserve thee from all evil. He shall preserve thy soul. The Lord shall preserve thy going out and coming in from this time forth and even forevermore. I waited patiently for the Lord, and he inclined unto me and heard my cry. He brought me up also out of a horrible pit, out of a wild clay, and set my feet upon a rock, and established my bones. And he hath put a new song in my mouth, even praise unto our God. Many shall see it and fear, and shall trust in the Lord. Blessed is that man that maketh the Lord his trust. God is our refuge and strength, a very present help in trouble. Therefore, will not be fear, though the earth be removed, and though mountains be carried into the midst of the sea, though the waters thereof roar and be troubled, though the mountains shake with the swelling thereof. Selah. There is a river, the streams whereof shall make glad the city of God, the holy place of the tabernacle of the Most High. The Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? The Lord is the strength of my life. Whom shall I be afraid? When the wicked, even my enemies and my foes, came upon me to eat of my flesh, they stumbled and fell. Though an host should encamp against me, my heart shall not fear. Though war should rise up against me, in this will I be confident. One thing have I desired of the Lord,
That will I seek after, that I may dwell in the house of the Lord all the days of my life, to behold the beauty of the Lord and to inquire in his temple. For in the time of trouble, he shall hide me in his pavilion. In the secret of his tabernacle shall he hide me. He shall set me upon a rock. And now shall my head be lifted up above my enemies, round about me. Therefore will I offer in his tabernacle sacrifices of joy. I will sing, yea, I will sing praises unto the Lord. Hear, O Lord, when I cry. When I cry with my voice, have mercy also upon me and answer me. When thou saidst, seek ye my face, my heart said unto thee, thy face, Lord, will I seek. Hide not thy face far from me. Put not thy servant away in anger. Thou hast been my help. Leave me not, neither forsake me, O God of my salvation. When my father and mother forsake me, then the Lord will take me up. Teach me thy way, O Lord, and lead me in a plain path because of my enemies. Deliver me not over unto the will of my enemies. For false witnesses are risen up against you, and such as breathe out cruelty. I had fainted unless I had believed to see the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. Wait on the Lord, and be of good courage, and he shall strengthen thine heart. Wait, I say, on the Lord. The Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. He restoreth my soul. He leadeth me in the path of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod, thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest the table before me in the presence of my enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil, my cup running over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. I will lift up mine eyes to the hills from which cometh my help. My help cometh from the Lord, which made heaven and earth. He will not suffer thy foot to be moved. He that keepeth thee will not slumber. Behold, he that keepeth Israel shall neither slumber nor sleep. The Lord is thy keeper. The Lord is thy shade upon thy right hand. The sun shall not smite thee by day, nor the moon by night. The Lord shall preserve thee from all evil. He shall preserve thy soul. The Lord shall preserve thy going out and thy coming in, from this time forward, and even forevermore. I waited patiently for the Lord, and he inclined unto me, and heard my cry. He brought me also out of a horrible pit, out of the miry clay, and set my feet upon a rock, and established my loins. And he put a new song in my mouth, even praise unto our God. Many shall sin and fear and trust in the Lord. Blessed is the man that maketh the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.
Yes, Lord. in this space together. And the scripture said, God said, suckle little children to come unto me. So I'm just going to say in this moment, I don't have any answers, but I do have a yes in my heart. I'm just telling God yes in every moment. That's my advice to all of us. I want to, if we could present this order of service, we'll start out with opening scripture by Pastor R.B. Peterson. He will be the Old and New Testament. Then we will be followed by Elder Carolyn Rice Smith, who will do our prayer of comfort. Immediately following her will be a selection from the Christian Life Center Choir. Say amen for them as they come in that order. I'm going to ask you during the opening scripture that everyone except the family would stand for the scripture. Our Old Testament reading from Psalms 8. O Lord, our Lord, how excellent is your name in all the earth. You have set your glory above the heavens. Out of the mouths of babes and nursing infants, you have ordained strength. Because of your enemies, you may silence the enemy and the avenger. When I consider your heavens, the work of your fingers, the moon and stars which you have ordained, what is man that you are mindful of him? Or the son of man that you visit him? You have made him a little lower than the angels, and you have crowned him with glory and honor. And from the New Testament, Matthew 18, at that time the disciples came to Jesus saying, who then is greatest in the kingdom of heaven? Then Jesus called a little child to him, set him in the midst of them, and said, assuredly I say to you, unless you are converted and become as a little child, you will by no means enter the kingdom of heaven. Therefore, whoever humbles himself as this little child is the greatest in the kingdom of heaven. And whoever receives one little child like this in my name receives me.
So Heavenly Father, in the name of Jesus, Lord, we invoke your presence in this space right now in the name of Jesus. Father, we come with humble hearts, oh God. But God, we come bold before your throne. God, you say that we can come bold in the name of Jesus. So God, we come today on behalf of this family, God. God, we lift them up in the name of Jesus. God, we release the peace of God over their mindsets today in the name of Jesus. Send a refreshing God in the room today, God. God, with the heaviness, God, you are heavy load bearer. God, you are the heavy load carrier, God. God, we ask right now, God, move upon the hearts. Let the wings of your spirit, God, go in this place today, God. We lift them up, oh God, unto you today. Everyone that is mourning, oh God, in the name of Jesus. God, we thank you for this day. That even in this, God, you still are God. God, in this place, show yourself mighty unto them, oh God. Be our strength today, God. God, in every place of weakness, God, we declare in the name of Jesus that you are strength, oh God. God, let a soul even be saved, God, even in this, oh God. God, this one is for you, oh God. God, doing them, oh God, that only you can do in the name of Jesus. God, your word declares that earth has no sorrow that heaven can't heal today, God. But God, somewhere in the midst today, God, they feel, oh God, that this one is for you, God. Do unto them, oh God. God, the impossible that they fear. Nothing's impossible, God. With you, oh God, in the name of Jesus. Regulate the minds today, God, in the name of Jesus. God, I rebuke the devourer now, God, in the name of Satan. Every tormenting spirit, I bind you now in the name of Jesus. I command you to loose your hold in the name of Jesus. Repeat to be speaking in the name of Jesus. God, we thank you that you're ever present because you said you'll never leave nor forsake us. God, you're the rock in the weary land today, God. God, you're able to do anything but fail. God, in the midnight hour, God, whisper in the ear, oh God. When there is no word, oh God, but tears, your word declares that you kept them too, oh God. God, to be absent from the body is to be present with the Lord.
God, help them by and by, oh God, to understand, oh God, because they're not there with you, God. That they're resting in your presence, God. No more weeping, oh God. No more pain, oh God. No more sorrow, oh God. So God, move in this place today in the name of Jesus. Move in this place today, God, in the name of Jesus. God, we speak your word today, God. It cannot and will not return back void, oh God. God, we lift up to you today, oh God. In the name of Jesus, joy unspeakable joy. God, let them find you, oh God, in the midst of this place, oh God, that they'll find peace in you, oh God. In the name of Jesus, God, we thank you for being God. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. God, now show yourself mighty. Reveal, oh God. Do what you do, oh God. Do what you do, oh God. God, we call the people together today to lift them up, oh God. Lift up the arms, oh God. Cause love to abound, oh God, in this place, oh God. Father, we give you glory in the name of Jesus. So God, have your way in this place today. Let something be said, God, that will draw closer to you, oh God. The relationship will be built, oh God, in the name of Jesus. Father, we thank you in this day for being present, oh God, and evermore, oh God. So God, walk with them, talk with them, oh God, as they lean upon you, oh God, and not to their own understanding, oh God. God, we thank you today. Be God, the acclimator, the beginning and end of all things. God, you are the sovereign God. So God, show yourself mighty in this room today. Peace, be still. Peace, be still. Peace, be still. In the name of Jesus. And God, we praise you. We give you glory. Honor and praise. In Jesus' name, amen.
Christian Life Center, for our sister Sheila, we love you. God bless you. God bless this family. Uplift this family. And we're just going to encourage you. It's already been spoken. He is our strength. God is our strength. Strength like no other. We depend on him who cannot fail us, who upholds us every day. And we bless the name of God for being our strength. Like no other. Hallelujah. You are my strength. Strength like no other.
Strength like no God is our present help. To be absent from the body is to be present with the Lord, giving heed that we must all appear before the judgment seat of Christ, that everyone may receive the things done in his body, according to that which he hath done, whether it be good or bad. Right. Finally, my brethren, whatsoever things are honest, whatsoever things are pure, whatsoever things are lovely, whatsoever things be of a good report, yes, if there be any virtue, yes, if there be any praise, think on these things, those things which ye have both learned and received and heard,
yes,
and seen in me do, and the God of peace shall be with you.
Yes.
With deep sympathy, pastors Gerard and Loretta Rice Barnes, Secretary Carolyn Smith, Empowerment of Grace, and Shadow African Methodist Church. From Dunbar Elementary School to the family of Sabrina Dunnigan, there is an angel at the end of the road, and we must go through that gate.
Yes.
And there, in life, we cannot see, but our Father claims his own. Beyond the gate, your loved one finds happiness and rest, and there is comfort in the thought that a loving God knows best.
Right.
It is with deepest sympathy that we, the followers done by elementary school, extend our sincere sympathy to Miss Sabrina Dunnigan in the loss of her loved children.
Right.
Deontay Davis Jr., Nivea Dunnigan, Heaven Dunnigan, Jabari Johnson, and Loyal. We pray that you will find consolation in the words of Jesus, who says, cast all your cares on him, for he cares for you. And remember that earth has no sorrow that heaven cannot heal. We encourage you to lift up your eyes unto the hills from whence comes your help, knowing that all your help comes from the Lord, which made heaven and earth. He is the one who is able to wipe away your tears and heal your broken heart. May God forever bless, keep, and strengthen you. Humbly submitted, follower of Stemper Elementary School, Ms. Tiffany Brown, Principal, Ms. Kimberly Allen, Assistant Principal. Hi, Sabrina. This is Tierra Bean. I'm here to see you and your beautiful babies. I just want to say I'm sorry for your loss, honey, and that I love you. To the Dunnigan family from the East St. Louis Central Committee, I will give all of these to the family. From the village of Brooklyn, to the family of the children, God's little angel. A little angel came to earth one day. He gave only love, and then he went away. They'll never forget the love he has brought, his happy smile, the lessons he taught. It's hard losing someone who gives you only joy, then goes back to heaven to his Father above. Remember him always, and know in your heart you'll be with him one day. But for now, share the love and continue to say, thank God for you, my angel, who has now gone away. God bless you, family.
What we would have done,
We visualize that future that we worked for, that we planned for, that we hoped for. All these things bring us pain. Pain unspeakable. And none of these things is important. In Philippians 4:8, we're told to fix our thoughts on what is true, honorable, right, pure, lovely, admirable, excellent, worthy of praise. At Dunbar School, it's our mission to create an environment where our children feel treasured. We have to focus on how we were able to enhance the life of the children. Both in person and in the virtual setting, we have to remember how Deontay, Heaven, and Nevaeh were all able to feel special individually and know they were cared for at a place called Dunbar. And we want to thank you so much for allowing us to be in a part of that village to make their lives so special. No one knows your struggle right now. We can only pray that one day the memory of the life that they live and the goodness in their hearts will bring some comfort to you. It might not be today, and it might not be tomorrow, but you will get there. Amen.
That. I want to announce that, would you please, for the men that have their hats on, would you please, in reference to this place, wear your hats. I also want to ask you, would you pull your mask up over your nose, please? Can we do that together? Amen?
Amen.
We one big family. Let's give each other a hand. Amen. At this point, I'm going to begin to take a look at some liberties as we do a little bit of changing, but we won't add more time, I promise you. At this point, we want to have a selection from Cedric Shannon Reeves. After that time, we will do Reflections of Life, silently, and then from that moment, we will change a tad bit.
Amen. Praise the Lord, everybody. Come on, praise the Lord again. Can I ask a question? Do I have any believers, any saved folk in the room? I know the family may be a little heavy right now, but everybody that came to be a strength to the family, will you do me a favor? I want you to jump up on your feet real quick and just release praise in this atmosphere. Come on. Get all those symbols. Help me out, drum. I want everything. Get a joyful noise. I'll tell the Lord, serve the Lord with gladness. If there comes before us, serve it with singing. And know ye that the Lord, He is God. Somebody shout, hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. We're going to worship a little bit. Hallelujah. Just praise the Lord. I've had some good days. I've had some hills to climb. I've had some weary days. I won't complain. Sometimes the clouds hang low. And have I got a witness that says sometimes that I can hardly see the road? I ask the question, Lord, why? Hey, hallelujah. Although my weakness
And even when I don't understand what you're doing, God, I'm still learning every day to say, thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. I won't complain. Because here's the truth of the matter. God has been good to me.
Good Lord.
He's been so good to me. Well, let me say, I wish I had a church in here. Yeah.
Come on, somebody. Hallelujah.
Sheila Dunnigan are going to be the two town representatives to do that, and then we will move forward from there.
share his word with you all. I want to encourage the family that they are with God today. However, I wanted to have some backup with me. So I got some scriptures. Matthew 19 and 14. But Jesus said, "Let the little children come to me, and do not hinder them, for to such belongs the kingdom of heaven." Deuteronomy 1 and 39. "Moreover, your little ones, which you said should be praised, and your children, which in the day had no knowledge between good and evil, they shall go in thither, and unto them will I give it all. They shall possess it." Psalms 127:3. "Children are an heritage of the Lord, and the fruit of the womb is his reward." Matthew 18:10. "Take heed that ye despise not one of these little ones, for I say unto you that in heaven their angels do always behold the face of my Father which is in heaven." Luke 2:41-42. "Now his parents went to Jerusalem every year at the feast of Passover. And when he was 12 years old, they went up according to custom." The Jewish religion or custom has a thing where between the day they were born until 11 years old, they're not counted for their sins. Amen. Now we all were born into sin, but they didn't have that, because between the ages of 0 to 11, we don't have the knowledge of good and evil. So God give us a grace period. It's called, it's considered a training period. That's why he says, train up a child in the way they should go. And when they become old, they should not go astray. God bless.
And support. And Sabrina, I want you to know we love you. Yes. And that you're not alone.
Yes.
I want you to know that we all know, your whole entire family know.
Yes.
That you was a great mom.
Yes.
And that you loved those children.
Yes.
But most of all, the good Lord know. He knew that you loved those children. That's why he gave them to you. And they're home with him. Again, with him. I don't know how long it's going to take for things to normalize in your life. How long the pain will last. But I want you to know, I'll always be praying for you. I'll always be praying for your strength. And I'll always be that TT that you can lean on. I love you, baby girl.
All right. Amen.
Amen. Now, we continue to sort of restructure. We're going to now, in this order, the praise dance tribute from the Triple Diamond Dancers will come next. When they're done, we're going to hear remarks. We have, and they're going to just come right up, Pastor, from this order. Pastor Mark Ratliff, Pastor Kendall Granger, Pastor April Bell, Minister Doug Hollis, Pastor Theodore Terry, and then, of course, our illustrious Mayor Easter, followed up in that order. I'm going to ask you to hold your remarks for 2 to 3 minutes. In respect for the family. Say amen for everybody in that room.
Well, put your hands together as they come. Put your hands together.
God. Lay hands on your head. And realize, and then we enjoy those young people. Come on, let's celebrate them. I'm going to get out of the way. The Bible tells us in all things to give thanks. I'm glad somebody can understand what I'm saying. God said he would be our refuge in the very time of trouble, even when our hearts are sad. Amen. But I certainly give honor to God, who is the head of my life, and to his son Jesus and to the Holy Spirit. We certainly honor all of the clergy that is here today, and to the eulogist, Reverend Barnes. Amen. We honor this family, to the parents and grandparents, to the aunts, uncles, and friends. Our heart and go out with you in prayer and in comfort, for we've been praying from the very first day. And I just thank God, along with working with our great mayor and being a part of this community, that we were able to be a help to you in this time to come to this point. So I'm not going to take up much more time. And I thought about one little scripture, and it said, suffer little children, come unto me, and forbid them not. I heard the preacher earlier say, this is all in God's hands. My mind just took off. Because when it's in God's hands, when it's in God's hands, one writer said, little is much when God is in it. And when you understand when God is in it, you can put your trust in him. You can rest assured that everything will be all right. Another said, amen, it'll be all over in the morning. So we say to this family, even in your heartaches, trust God. Trust God. God will never leave you. And when the doors shut in the room and you're by yourself, you may not be able to call family and friends at the moment.
Watch out.
Does anybody know you can call on the Lord? You can call him early in the morning. And you can call him at noonday. But I found out sometimes that anybody has the ever call him late at night. I say to you, my brothers and sisters, to this mother, call on the Lord. If I may, clergy, will you please allow me? We are blessed. Our mayor, Hannah, who has been working with us, amen, is here today. And clergy, we understand you will fall right back in line. Instead of having our mayor come last, we're going to bring him up with you. Receive our honorable mayor. Amen. Mayor Robert Easton.
Good afternoon. Before I read the letter I wrote, I just want you to turn to your neighbor and say, I need you to catch these hands. They ain't hear you, turn to the other person and say, you need to catch these hands. And just like Pastor just said, it's in these hands. So it's going to be in these hands, and he's going to mend your heart. It's going to be in these hands. His unchanging hand. His unchanging hand. Anybody that sit on that front row know what I'm talking about. Because he can change. He can heal with these unchanging hands. So I need you to do what? Catch these hands. Catch these hands. To the parents, family, and friends of Dante, D'Avia, Haven, Jabari, and L'Oreal, I would like to express my heartfelt sympathy to the family on behalf of the East St. Louis. I know there's mourning and lives that have moved us on extremely difficult to bear. Even though I've never had the pleasure of meeting these children, I know that they were a crucial part of this community, this show. We will like to make sure that they're not forgotten. And our prayer as a community is that you remember the love that you had for them. Their parents, their family, they cherish the friends they made and the hearts of the strangers they impacted. We understand that there is no words that can ease these pains of this loss. However, we want to offer more than words. The community of East St. Louis and the city of East St. Louis, we stand with you. We grieve with you. We are committed to walking alongside of you for always. At this hour of difficulty, I pray that the family and friends of these beautiful children find peace reflecting on the moments you shared with them. Find that peace. Find that peace. I know each one of you will mourn independently, but I hope that you rely on another thing to get you through these days, these hands. During your quiet moments when you're alone, I hope this poem will offer you a moment of peace, of healing, because it has given me, that it has given me. Dear Lord, if flowers bloom in heaven, pick them all for me. Give them to my babies and place them at their feet. If flowers bloom in heaven, send a breeze for me. That reminds me of the memories we shared. If the flowers bloom in heaven, shine the sunlight through their smiles and let them know that I won't stop planting the flowers, that they remind me of them. If flowers bloom in heaven, help me water them for me. Remind them every day that I'm here too, watching the flowers that they bloom in heaven. There's nothing that God cannot heal. Those that love, we simply don't go away. They walk beside us, they guide us and change us. Please reach out to me. Reach out to me if there's anything that I can do. And I just want to say, on behalf of the East St. Louis Police Department,
all right.
Fire Chief McCullen, who was on the scene, we're praying for you as well. Amen. And I need you to pray for them as well. Amen. We stand with you as a community, and we are one. We are the City of Champions. We are the City of Champions. And champions always find a way to win.
Five-fold ministry gifts, amen, to the dignitaries, God bless you.
All right.
Everyone in the respectful places, amen. Now that we got all the delivery out the way,
yes, sir.
To this great family,
yeah.
To this woman of God, to this man of God, and to the aunts, the uncles, and to the entire family.
Well.
Amen. I just want to come and to let you know that I have been praying for you, have not stopped praying for
amen.
You, interceding for you.
Yes.
Because I believe that we are a family.
Right.
And I don't just believe that we are a family, that when tragedy strikes and when tragedy hits, we are family, we come together. One thing about me, Pastor April, I'm going to ride for my city. I'm sorry, y'all, I'm a little hood. I'm a pastor, but I still got a little hood in me. I'm going to ride for my city. And outside of this suit and outside of this jacket, I don't mind getting dirty for the city. I don't mind getting dirty for the people. To let y'all know, I love you. I'm not just saying this because it sounds good and because it looks good to be behind this sacred desk. It's because it comes from my heart. Now listen, I was asking God, I said, God, give me something. I need a word.
Come on.
Help me to help.
Come on now.
This daughter. Yeah. Your beloved. Give me something that will help her. Because I just got off the road and I came straight here. And I say, God, I was weeping because I'm dropping my daughter off at college. I'm leaving. Uh-huh. And my baby, I'm leaving her behind. And I say, but God, here's the next task. I have to go and stand here and talk.
Come on now.
I say, God, give me something that will move not only the heart of the mother and the heart of the fathers, God, but move this entire setting. God, give me a word. I said, God, give me a word. And the Lord began to speak to me as we drove up 57 coming back from Chicago. The Lord began to say, he said, April, those babies have had a seat at the table. I said, God, what are you talking about? He said, they have made it to the table. He said, those babies, they have made it to the table. He said, they are at the table dining real sumptuously. The Bible, the Christ in the Message version of the Bible, they're dining in front of a six-course meal with the five. Now, I used to have a problem, Pastor, because they would ask me to come up and we will quote this scripture and we will quote it so profoundly and so prolifically to be absent from the body is to be present with the Lord. And I said, God, is that really true? But God said, April, you ain't got to worry today to be absent from this body is to be present with the Lord. He said, you ain't got to worry about them. They are at the table. They have made it to the table. It hurt. But God's going to heal you, daughter. God's going to heal you. He's going to heal you. He's going to comfort you. And he's going to hashtag restore you back to where you belong. I don't care what they say. God said, he's going to restore you back to where you belong. Now this is what God said. He said, April, now I want you to leave something for the congregation. Yes. Hey! I had to text my mentor. I said, you told me when you come before the dignitaries, you act dignified. But it's something about the anointing when it's shifts in the atmosphere. See, I don't know about y'all, but I only need 5 seconds and one memory. And I understand that greater is he that is in me than he is in the world. So if the greater one is in me, that means that I have the ability to transfer the Spirit of God in the atmosphere. And it can do what my voice can't do. It can strengthen her. So listen, I'm going to my seat.
It's all right.
The Lord said that. He said, April, the babies have made it to the table. He said, they are at the table and they dining with the Father. Oh, they're right there with the Father, the Heavenly Father. He said, they have made it. Now the Lord told me, he said, now ask every one of these individuals that's in the building, will you make it to the table if your number is called? I beseech you, therefore, brethren, by the mercies of God, consider the table. Yeah.
Praise the Lord, everybody. It's kind of hard to come behind the table. My God.
You're all right,
y'all. Hey, listen. They already made all the attributes to all, to my friend, Merritt Easton, my buddy, Chief, amen, Fire Chief, and to all these clergies, Pastor Radcliffe, and to the woman that's going to bring the words. Listen, me being a basketball coach and a soccer coach and a baseball coach and coaching, and I was just like Pastor Bell, ask God, what can I say? And as I began to ride and think about sports and realized that I had a basketball game and then forgot all about it, I thought about the five.
Watch out now.
Yeah, you know, in a basketball game, you have to have five players on the court. Talk back to me, somebody. And when you got those five players on the court, you got to have a point guard. You got to have a shooting guard. You got to have two forwards. Then you got to have a center. And when I realized the main thing, what folks understand about the game, the point guard makes all the decisions. Come on, somebody. But if you got a good center, talk back to me, somebody. I'm going somewhere with this. If you got a good center, then you can dominate the game. So all of y'all sitting today, y'all didn't come here just because of these babies. These babies just made it to the championship. And when they made it over to the championship, they was wondering how was they going to win because they didn't have a sub. You know, once you get in foul trouble, you need a sub, substitution. And then when somebody foul out, you need somebody to sub for that person. And I can imagine my sanctified mind. When one of them fired out, God say, I'm standing in the midst, talk back to me, somebody. I'll play whatever position you want me to play. So we didn't come out. I'm about to go because I'm just a crazy sanctified preacher. And I feel a dance in my spirit. Because you know when you win a championship game, you can have it. And you celebrate. And then sometimes when you celebrate, you just run all over the place. And I'm about to take off running. But I came to leave with the family as I go to my seat. Because I only need a minute and 30 seconds. Isaiah 40 and 31 said, they that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up. I'm not the preacher, but I just have it right now. They shall mount up with wings. They shall roar. So baby, in the morning, Sabrina, you're going to need some strength. When the phone calls stop, when everybody go their separate ways, and you're by yourself, you're going to need somebody to call on. You can't call on Mama Linda. You can't call on TT. You can't call on boyfriend. You can't call on baby daddy, but oh, God. You say, I'll be there for you. First, it's all right to cry. Cry tears of joy. Because you will see him again. Yeah. So we didn't come to tell these babies goodbye. We came to tell them good night. We'll see them in the morning. Saturday morning. When it's all
giving some remarks. And I asked the Lord, what do you want me to say? And he said, pen these words. And I said, as I always do, are you sure? And he said, yes. So coming from the Lord, the question of why is a question that you and I will never understand as we journey through life.
pondering in search of answers, searching for answers to the unexplainable. The absence of reason might leave us with a void. So many unknowns, so many what-ifs. But I want you to know that we, the members of the clergy, the city officials, and others, we are here with you. And this is not a journey that you have to take alone. As a warrior of the faith, I want you to know that hope is alive and active in our hearts, minds, and souls. A stable that we must cling to daily with faith. Hebrews chapter 11, starting at verse 1, begins with, reminds us that faith is assurances of things hoped for, the convictions of things not seen. Hope gives us the endurance and confidence we need to persevere with the necessary strength and courage, to push forward with boldness. Hope does not leave us idling or drifting, is innate and life-sustaining. A directive from God, our source, which allows us to evolve beyond our current capacity. To have hope is to have faith, and to have faith is to have hope. God bless you, and God keep you.
May God bless each one of our speakers. What an amazing job. And now we're about to prepare for the conclusion of matter for today. After Brother Reeves comes back and sings for us another time, the next voice you hear will be that of Pastor Loretta Rice Barnes, Pastor of Empowerment of Grace Church, founder of Global Impact Leadership Alliance, founder of Metro East Organizing Collaborative, and co-pastor with me in Indianapolis at New Seasons Fellowship Church. And we are so grateful to have her. So after you hear the voice of this amazing soloist, we'll then be in the hands of our eulogist, Pastor Rice Barnes.
All right.
Testing. All right. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. I'll tell you a story really quick. God sent his son. They call him Jesus. He came to love, heal, and forgive. Bled and died, glory to God, to buy my pardon and empty grave. Come on, help me, drummer. Is that a proof my Savior lives? And because he lives, I can face tomorrow. Glory to God. Have I got just one witness on this side? Because he lives. What am I waiting to back back now? All fear is gone. Because life is worth the living just because he lives, because he lives. I'm going to need a little help from somebody that knows what I'm talking about.
we get to this part of the service, we give God praise. Because as you have heard it spoken earlier, the Bible has told us and instructed us in all things, in the good things, in all things, in the bad things, in all things, in sorrow, in all things, in sadness, in all things, that we will give God thanks. Glory to God. As we've heard to all of the clergy, the fivefold ministry that's in the house, and to the dignitaries that are here, and to all of those that have participated, to Serenity, to the family, extended family that's here of the community, to the friends, and to this beloved family that's here on today. Will you all celebrate them? Come on, show them some love. You can do better than that. Show some love. Come on, come on, come on. Because as we have been spending time together over this past week or so, I've watched Mama, Miss Linda, to Sabrina, to Lamario, to Deontay, to Miss Jackie, to all of the aunts, to Sheila D, Sheila B, Melody, who I've met, to Jamila, those just some of the names of people that I've encountered, to the grandparents, to the cousins. God bless you. I've watched them over the past week or so gather strength from the love of the community. The love of the community that have come together to stand as one. Somebody say one.
One.
That have come together to stand as one. Something happens when we operate in the spirit of unity. The Bible says that wherever the spirit of unity is, or the spirit of liberty is, that God commands a blessing. And wherever there is the spirit of liberty, there is freedom.
Come on now.
And wherever there is the spirit of unity, God commands a blessing. I think I got some praying people in the house. You've heard from clergy and many people who are standing with you, Deontay, and to Lamario, and to Sabrina, that have come to be with you in this moment. And as you have heard even earlier today, was likewise my words to God. What is it that you want me to say? What is it that you would want me to speak to the family? How do we begin to wrap our minds around such a situation to be able to process it? Our natural minds cannot even begin to perceive what we are here for today. One of the things that I realized that as a mother, and as we spent time yesterday, Sabrina, and being with you and watching you and seeing all of the amazing pictures of you with the babies and the smiles and all of the things that I've heard of your love and support, and even God strategically allowed me to be at Dunbar just this past week, not even realizing that that was the school that the babies were at, but how he brought everything together for this moment. How I learned about them being on honor roll and everything that you put on the inside of them. And one of the things that came to me even as I was sitting down is that the Bible has declared in the book of Ecclesiastes, there is a time and a season for all things. Oh yes. There's a time, the Bible says, for us to plant. There's a time for us to pluck up. There's a time for us to build. There's a time for us to tear down. I think I got some praying people up in the house on today. Glory to God. There's a time to be born.
Come on now.
And there's a time to die. One of the things is that none of us know the day or the hour that the Son of Man is coming. None of us know the day or the hour that the Lord is going to call our number. But look at somebody and say, you got to be ready. Or look at somebody else that you didn't look at and tell them, you got to be ready. You got to be ready whenever God calls your number. I like to get down right and dirty. I'm a pastor. I put on my stilettos and all of that. But I like being in the trenches, right in the gutter of the community, because Jesus said it like this. I came to seek and to save those that are lost. He wants to touch us. And see, if we are confined inside of the four walls of the edifice where it's all beautiful, we're going to miss something. Oh, somebody better talk to me up in here. So some of you all, many of you all, but you've never saw me behind this side of the desk. But let me tell you something. Whatever God has called you to do, look at somebody and say, you better do it. See, for me, it doesn't matter because dignitaries are in the house. It doesn't matter to me if the president of the U.S. is in the house or the parliament members of foreign countries are in the house, because when God calls our numbers, we gotta stand before him. Somebody better talk to me up in here. Glory to God, there's nobody else that we're gonna be able to answer to. Not your pastor, your bishop, your archbishop, your chief apostle, your teacher, your dignitaries, your whatever. Sabrina Lamario Deonte, parents, children. What shall we say to these things? As a mother that has a child and experience deep pain from the child, what do you do when you get to this point? Oh God. See, because one of the things is the reality of what's happening here. The reality of the moment where we are. And as it was said even earlier, that when all the calls stop and all of that and the time passed and all those things, one of the things that I understand is that late in the midnight hour, you know the song, they sing it like this, God is going to turn it around. He said that if you call on me, I will answer you. What am I saying? That even as the babies have slipped away to be with the master, when your mind can't even conceive what has happened, when you get up to want to go to make breakfast and pull out clothes and thinking about school and I got to get them ready and all those things, because it's a reality, Deonte, and then you realize something drastic has happened. My life has changed. The things that I used to have to do, I'm no longer finding myself having to do those things anymore. I need some praying people up in here. Today, if I was going to tag the message, and I wrestled, I talked it over with my husband, I had all kind of titles, you know, wrote down, and you know, you talk about your my main topic and your subtopic and topic A and topic B and all of that. But one of the things that the Lord downloaded into my spirit, somebody shout, radical love.
Radical love.
Say it, radical love.
Radical love.
Radical love in this moment is going to cause for what?
Radical love.
I need some people to talk back to me.
Come on now.
Radical love. In times like these, we need a savior. In times like these, we need the Lord. As I was preparing and saying, God, what do you want me to say? How, what word do I talk about the peace of God? Somebody say the peace of God. In Colossians, the 3rd chapter, the 15th verse in the King James Version, it says, and let the peace of God rule in your hearts, to which also ye are called in one body, and be ye thankful. The Amplified Bible, I like the Amplified. This is the classic edition of the Amplified. And it says this, and let the peace, soul harmony, which comes from Christ, let it rule. Let it act as umpire, continually umpire, a person appointed to rule on place. Now, Minister Doug laid it out for us earlier because he talked about the five people on, you know, the court. I know the men know what I'm talking about. You know, I ain't played basketball since junior high school, so, you know, I don't remember a lot of stuff because I didn't got old, and, you know. But the umpire, let the umpire rule. In your hearts, deciding and settling with finality all the questions, Sabrina, Lamario, Deontay, all of the questions, Grandma, Grandpa, aunties, all of the questions that arise in your mind. Let the peace of God, let it act as umpire, settling the finality of all the questions. Somebody say all the questions. All the questions that arise in your mind in that peaceful state, to which as members of Christ, one body, you are also called to live and be thankful and appreciative. I pondered on whether or not I would talk about love. In moments like these, we are struggling to get to a place, Mayor, to find peace and to find comfort and turn into things sometimes that's not even fulfilling for us. It's just feeling good to us in the moment. But when we get done with those things, we also understand that we still need a setting. We still need some peace that passes all understanding. For God so loved the world. Oh, yes he did. Yes he did. That he gave his only begotten son. Only. Whenever I think of only, your only child. Only. That means all. Abraham comes to mind.
Watch out.
Abraham, which was called to sacrifice his child. Sabrina, what were you preparing the babies for? Mother, father, grandmothers. As the peace of God that rests, ruleth, and abideth within, preparing for the master, they said, suffer not the little children. Didn't they say that earlier? Love that's deeply rooted, love that covers, and above all things, love. As one of the aunts were speaking and saying, God, what are you trying to say to us in this moment? The Bible says that God used the foolish to confound the wise. Things that are beyond our understanding that we may not understand here, but they say that you understand it better. What?
Come on now.
The laughter of the children, the smiles, the beauty, everything that you get to hold on in your hearts. When your minds are overworked, Jesus, the Prince of Peace, is your medicine. It's going to take radical love of the community that's been here over the past week, radical love that brought you into the sanctuary, radical love beyond the sanctuary. It can't stop here. It can't stop here. Radical love, as Sheila called out earlier, for the family members to stand with one another. After you've done all you can, stand. I said I watched the family light up from the love. There is no words that we can speak out of our mouths right now to reach to the core. Only a living God. Only a living God can meet us and be right here with what you need. Where do we go from here? I tell you about a man named Jesus. You all know. Some of you all know. Some of you all get to know that in the midnight hour, when it's overwhelming, Somebody say Jesus.
Jesus.
In the midnight hour when you don't know what's going to be next, somebody shout Jesus.
Jesus.
In the midnight hour when there's no one else to call, somebody shout Jesus.
Jesus.
We'll be there with you.
Hallelujah.
Right in that place. So Father, we say thank you. Because your word told us to say thank you. We thank you, oh God, for the time that you allow. Sabrina, as the power of God continued to surround you, as the power of God continued to overshadow you, as the power of God continued to be present with you, somebody say Jesus.
Jesus.
Radical love, radical love, radical love, love that covers your minds and your hearts, and cover your spirits. So God, we give you praise and glory and honor. We thank you, God, for your word and for the anointing and for your power. Thank you, God, for your spirit, and thank you for the Holy Ghost. Because that's what it's going to take to keep us, to keep you in this moment. When the lights go down, radical love that lifts you up when your knees feel weak. Radical love that gives you strength in the midst of your sorrow. Radical love that calls your mind to be able to shift, to be able to say, God, show me. Show me what it is that you have for me right now. Radical love that rises us up when we want to fall down. Oh yeah, radical love. Radical love. The love that says when we are seeing our single mothers and fathers that we wrap our arms around them as a community. Radical love. Being proactive and not just responsive, but somebody shout what?
Radical love.
That's what we need in this moment. That's what we need in this moment. The love that reaches way down to the bottom. Mama Linda, Grandma Linda, that radical love that you've spread across the family to stand, to walk in joy, to walk in strength as you've groomed up your children, that radical love, aunties, that radical love that beyond this place, the community will be present. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Give the Lord some praise in this place. Come on, put your hands together and give him some praise. Come on, put your hands together and give him some praise in this place. He calls, he lives.
Now
hold
on.
I can face tomorrow. Because he lives, all your fears will be gone. Because I know who holds your future, and life is worth the living just because. You're going to be able to face tomorrow. You can face tomorrow. Oh yes, God. Because he lives. All of your fears will be gone. Because I know who holds your future.
sing.
Because he lives, he's gonna do it for you. All your fears will be gone.
Oh, oh, I'm going up beyond that. I'm gonna tell this world goodbye. You see, I'm gonna fly away. We're gonna be caught up together till we Jesus Christ forever. You see, I'm gonna fly away. I will be free, free someday. Oh, tell this world goodbye. You see, I'm gonna fly away. We're gonna be all up together till we Jesus Christ forever. You see, I'm gonna fly away. I will be free, free one day. Yeah, 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 yeah. Walking up the King's Highway. 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 Highway to heaven. Man can walk up there, but that pure heart, it's a highway to heaven. Walking up the King's Highway. Lord, I will live my nights to the hills. No. My head, my
We stretch our hands.
said, you know, another minute, not an hour of another day. Lord, she needs you right away. Right away. Right away. Right away. Oh, right, Holy Spirit, right away. Come, Lord Jesus, right away. Oh, Shepherd, right away. Peace, right away. Oh, Holy Spirit, right away. The agony of being alone, fear of doing things on our own, tests and trials that come to make us strong. Oh, the feelings of guilt, hurt, shame, and defeat weigh the trial that beat upon us.
Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. but I've been blessed with a very talented staff. So I'm going to take this opportunity to thank Ms. Tan Gates. See, she heads my media department, and she turns my vision into reality. So we want to thank her for the graphics that are on the children's back. But each child, their hobbies, the toys they like, the colors, are all depicted on their canvas. Even though these are tragic times, I wanted to do something that for just an instant would take your mind away from the tragedy and focus on the beauty of the children. You see, sometimes we grieve, but there's a definition for grief that I like to say. Grief is love with no place to go. So if we take the love that we all have for these children and apply it to other family members, other friends, their legacy will live on forever. So, God bless you. And with that, I want to pause for a few brief but important observations. You say I'm going to thank you in advance for your cooperation, but my desire is that you remain in your places until the family has been escorted from the sanctuary. Now, I'm asking for all the designated pallbearers to assemble on the west wall, all the pallbearers. Now, pallbearers, do a count for me, because at the end of your count, I need to have 20 pallbearers assembled. So if we don't have enough designated pallbearers, then I'm going to ask for volunteers. So the pallbearers, please assemble on the west wall.
kept this casket right here. This casket is off the head.
I went, what's up, y'all?